What's up, everybody? It's your favorite, or don't you put that in your pipe and smoke his favorite nerd. And today we are looking at the Bad Cube Piper, which is their take on pipes. Once again, this is on loan to me from Titan One. They knew I wasn't going to buy it, and they still sent it to me to look at, so I appreciate them. The link to their store is in the description, and I suggest you take a look as well. So, I decided to go from bot to truck in this mode. Even though the engineering is different, I just felt like, I don't know, I'm not sure if it was the right decision or not, but you know, when the transformations are similar, I do like to go the other way so that I can give people an idea of how to change it both ways on my channel. That being said, there is enough different here where I'm not sure I made the right call, but it's the call I made and it was mine to make. That being said, I want to give my heartfelt thoughts to the folks in Florida and in Houston that have been hit pretty bad by the weather recently. I hope you guys fared well. I can only imagine what that sort of devastation can cause a person. That being said, I just know I'm thinking of you. But we're going to start with accessories, which are fairly limited. Apparently, there were some animation errors, and his eyes were red from time to time in the animation, so they gave you that option, and then they gave you the toy option. Both are painted and such. It's on a white plastic, as you can see, so the blue and red are both painted and done well. The other accessory is this bit of business, which I'm not entirely sure. I'm sure they did a write-up about it, because they did a write-up about everything. After a hard-fought battle with the evil robots, Piper was finally able to capture the final instrument to reactivate their city-sized oh, it's the Eye of Metroplex. So I guess that's from that episode. Light piping in here, does it work fairly well? Yes, it does. Silver paint, translucent orange, it's well enough. And, you know, if you position him and such, he can kind of hold it with tension or gravity. So that's sort of the options there. So let's talk about the figure. Looks okay.
Don't you think?
Until you get to this, and then it looks a bit of a mess. Now the truck is supposed to hang off of his back, so it's a tricky one to pull off. I'm just not sure that this is the best way to go about it, but then again, I'm not sure it's the worst. So there is this huge bit of kibble here on the back. Be aware. The head is on the same ball peg as Huff, so you get a good bit up, a little bit, not really anything down, and the swivel. Eyes are painted a metallic blue, and the blue is painted on the head. There is some paint in here on the chest as well. I don't know if this doesn't feel like die-cast to me, where I felt like the Huff one did. He does have die-cast in the feet, and the feet are painted. And then this is that I think this is just that glossy plastic down here for the blue, but it does, the blue glossy plastic does work better than the orange glossy plastic, that I will admit. And then it's just white plastic here, silver paint on the pipes on the arms. So let's talk about, that's pretty much all the paint that we have to talk about in terms of the figure. Most of the paint comes through in truck mode. So let's just talk about the accessories, I mean the articulation at this point. So the arms are the same. They're basically on a, oh, this is a hinge. I thought the hover was on a ball peg. Maybe I was wrong there. Hope not. If I was, I'm sure you let me know. This ball peg is actually in the shoulder though. So it comes out to basically a hinge here to a ball peg. So I guess it's kind of reversed. At least I think so anyway. Either way, it gives you the arm up to there and around in terms of till the backpack stops it. These you can get out of the way. They clip down here, but you can get them out of the way if you need to get the arm up, and then you can clip them back down. Bicep swivel, single hinged elbow gets you 90 degrees. The wrist swivel and the fingers are on a base pin knuckle. Same for the other side. Waist swivel, no problems there. The same universals for hips, which gets you the full Van Damme and the full Monty. We have this white plastic. Now the white plastic is mixed down here with white paint on blue. That's going to be a tricky one. Be careful with that because that'll chip and it's hard to cover that dark blue with that white, but they did a pretty good job, I must say. Thigh swivel, single hinge knee gets you 90 degrees. Down here we have the ankles. You have a tilt up, a tilt down, a heel spur kind of hinge, and a rocker. So no issues there kind of whatsoever in terms of articulation. Just it's really in terms of bot mode, you know, Yikers Island. And there the two kind of mold mates are. I did end up buying him because I'm weak. I don't know. It's, you know, obviously he was the intention and he is the, how can we make this work? Now there he is with the X-Transbots pipes. And this one I will not be swapping out. This one doesn't compel me to do so, and I certainly don't care about this character, really. And I think that the chrome kind of looks pretty cool. Like, it's a little bit more striking on the shelf. So this one I definitely won't be striking out. But swapping out, not striking out, good grief. Either way, there they are next to one another. And size comparison-wise, there he is with some mini bots. So, you know, once again, I think he fits in nicely. The transformation for the legs is fairly similar to Huff. Open these bits up here and flip these pieces open. Flip these pieces out here. And this one's a little trickier to get to for me. And there. And then you can kind of set the wheel. You can, this comes down like this. The foot goes back inside. And sits in that little notch there. And then the heel comes down to cover the back. So same on this side. Heel comes down, covers the back. The legs can actually tab together at that point. And then these pieces come down, and these pieces peg in to the square notches on the pelvis. This is a tight fit, especially this one, so be cautious. That one works a lot better. And that's the lower legs. We're going to break the upper body up into three sections. But the first is just sort of to untab this piece and untab these two pegs from here. You can get the cab out of the way. And then these pieces kind of butterfly in, and the arms come up. I think you can get the head out of the way as well. I'm not exactly sure what the position is there. I'll double check. But rotate these pieces in so that the tires are sitting a little bit closer, and then this will eventually tab in there. Before we do that, we're going to just sit this down. We're going to tab that in. We're going to open this up here. Flip these pieces out here and here. Kind of keep these pieces out of the way. Bring out the side view mirrors. So unlike Huff, which sat on the outside of the vehicle, these fold into the inside of the vehicle, which is a nice touch. They didn't have to do that, so I do appreciate that. This comes down. And then these come in and secure it. And then we'll put all this together. So this is where everything kind of has to line up. Just tuck these arms down, rotate the pipes to the other side, and then flip them up. And I can tell you that this arm is already wrong, because you want it to kind of be almost 90 degrees, because you want these arms to sit up inside the cab. And then basically, this piece just comes up and over, and then these pieces come down to close up on the hands, and then this tabs in to the side here, and this to the side there, and that's him. And that's not, you know, like, I'll clean it up a bit, but we'll take a look at it. And there you have it. Once again, I'll show you a quick size comparison with Tiger Tracks. This is where most of the love, unfortunately, comes through in this thing. This does have the blue translucent, and you can see in and see all the guts, which isn't the cleanest. This does hook up to Optimus in the same way Huff's does. You know, it's fine. It's just, you know, it's generally unremarkable. Nice paint, the silver paint here, silver paint on the grill. You know, silver paint underneath, it looks like, with translucent pieces on top. Little silver accents there, yellow paint there, not done extremely well, but yellow's a hard cover to get, so I get it. Red and silver and gunmetal silver there on the back. Rolls fine, so like silver on the wheels. It's not like it's bad. It's just, you know, much like Huffer's, the positive aspects of this figure don't really come through in alt mode as well as they come through in robot mode, and they don't share the same positive attributes in robot mode. So this one is a little bit more complicated in terms of saying good or bad, because it's not as good as the one we just looked at, and yet it's not all that different either, you know. So it's interesting. I do like the way that this covers up a bit better, though.
Final thoughts wise for the negatives, the backpack transformation is not quite as elegant as the Huff backpack transformation, and even that one isn't all that elegant. So there is something, there's a little bit more Bad Cube feel to this backpack transformation. Not full-blown Bad Cube, but, you know, like diet Bad Cube, for lack of a better term. I do feel like the very simple kind of color palette works against this thing in terms of presentation, but that's definitely a subjective opinion. But really, I mean, ultimately, it just comes down to that sort of unsightly bit right there. That's a big strike against this fella, in my opinion. And I just feel like a lot more paint accents could be used on this guy with a very simple color scheme, just to kind of make it look a little bit more interesting. It just doesn't look as nice as it's made. That's a fair criticism here. Once again, plenty of positives to boot, though. I think that the paint that is applied well, and I think there's a fair amount of paint. It just doesn't come through as well, unfortunately. The sculpt is good, you know, with the exception, this isn't really a sculpt issue, that's an engineering issue, so we can't really hold that against them in terms of sculpt. But I just don't think that he presents all that well. But mostly he's made fairly well across the board. I am noticing a significant little stress mark down in here that I hadn't noticed before, but there it is. But yeah, I have to, at the end of the day, I have to recommend him. I think that he's pretty good. I think that he's probably the best built pipes available. I'm just not sure if he's the best looking one, and that's a matter of subjectivity. So if you like the way that this looks, if this does it for you, it's certainly very G1. There's nothing for me to say not to get it. It's a fairly well bit, which is like built, only not spelled nor pronounced the same. What is going on with me? I feel like I'm living in a fog, am I right? Either way, thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Until next time, take care.